In this episode, we're going to take a look at coupling lasers into fiber optic cables. So let's go. So lately I've been experimenting with fiber optic cable. This is actually really, really interesting stuff with applications that go far beyond telecommunications. In fact, you can use fiber optic cable for all sorts of weird and wonderful stuff, like you can use it for remote sensing. You can actually use the cable itself as a sensor. You can measure temperature with it. You can measure high voltage with it. You can probably measure magnetic fields with it. All sorts of really, really interesting stuff. At the moment, I've actually got a couple of really cool projects in the works involving fiber optic cable. And so I would say to you, if you're not subscribed to this channel already, you should absolutely do so, because there's some really, really cool stuff coming up in the future. For most of my projects, I'm actually going to be using standard telecommunications cable. This stuff is dirt cheap because it's everywhere. I picked this up, it's about 35 meters, picked it up from Amazon for about 15 bucks. So very, very cheap. I do have a collection of non-standard fibers that I've picked up off eBay for various other projects. This is a 100 micron silica fiber. It's a particularly large diameter fiber for certain specialist applications. But yeah, for the most part, telecoms fiber all the way. This has standard connectors on the end. We've got an ST connector on here. That's like a little bayonet connector, and we can connect it up to, you know, whatever patch panels or whatever normally with our little bayonet connector on the end there. What I'm really interested in, and the topic of this video, is how to couple laser light into these things in a sort of sensible fashion, get the maximum light traveling through the fiber that we can. If I take this piece of multimode fiber and a laser pointer, we'll see if we can get some light coupled into it just by shining a laser in the end. So we'll just pop off the ends real quick. There we are, point them towards the camera, and we'll try and get some laser light coupled in there. We might see a little flash. Not very much light is being coupled in at all. And so we need a method of efficiently coupling our lasers into the fiber. Fortunately, it's possible to buy fiber optic collimators, and this is an example of one. This is an FC connector, and the FC connectors seem to be the most common for fiber optic cable, but very, very simply, it's just a little barrel assembly with a lens mounted on the front that we couple our light into the fiber with. I'll just unscrew this and we'll have a look. Don't mean anything too exciting in there. That's it. It's just a threaded barrel with a lens. That's all there is to it. And I suppose we could attempt to try and couple some light in with a laser pointer. We'll give this a go. It won't work out very well. We'll talk about why that is shortly, but let's screw on our collimator. And we'll see if we can couple any more light in. Now, this will be janky as, right? It's not likely to work very well, but we'll give it a go. And we maybe get one or two very, very tiny flashes out the end of the cable. We don't seem to be doing very well at all, right? So yeah, let's look at how we might effectively couple light into these cables. So as we saw, just simply pointing a laser pointer in the end of a fiber cable can't really be expected to work very well at all. I mean, the beam diameter of this is about 4 or 5 millimeters, and the fiber core diameter on the end of our cable is about 9 microns. So, I mean, we're only going to couple in a very, very small amount of light. Even when we have the fiber optic coupler hooked up to the end of the cable, we're still not effectively coupling in the light. The light will only get coupled into the core of the cable if everything is perfectly aligned. So I have a diagram here where we have a fiber tip, and in the middle, the line represents our 9 micron spot. And if we can get light to go into the end of the coupler very, very straight and very, very precisely, then it's not beyond the bounds of possibility that we could focus our light into the very end of the fiber. If we're off, we're off center or off axis by even, you know, fractions of a degree. I'll draw an exaggerated diagram here, but if we're off by fractions of a degree, then we're probably going to focus light that's going to end up, you know, significantly away from our target 9 micron center. It's nothing to do with the accuracy of this cheap collimator. This came off of AliExpress and cost about 15 bucks. So they're relatively, you know, they're relatively inexpensive, but there's nothing mechanically unsound about this. We need a sensible way of coupling light in there on axis. About fiber collimators, I thought that 15 bucks for this was quite expensive. And since I have such a variety of fiber connectors on the selection of cable that I have, I've actually made a bunch of my own. So here's one for ST connectors that I've put together. And I've got another one here for the SMA 905 connector. This is just a standard SMA connector that I've punched out the electrical pin that was normally in there, and then silver soldered on a collimator assembly from a laser diode like this. These lens assemblies for inexpensive laser diodes can be had for you can get for 10 in a bag for a couple of bucks, right? And so very, very inexpensive indeed. And so I've got a whole selection of these things. Here's another one that couples to FC cable. This is another homemade connector. And to get the FC style coupling, I've just used standard FC coupler and turned one end off in the lathe and then silver soldered my laser diode collimator onto the end of it. We've got effective means of focusing the light. We just need an effective means of directing the light in there and getting it absolutely square. In order to do super simple fiber coupling, we actually need a laser light source that's already coupled into one end of the fiber. And so to accomplish this, I've picked up a visual fault locator off of Amazon. This was $15 delivered. Not affiliated with Amazon or the manufacturer of these things, but let's have a look. Looks a little bit like a torch. It's basically a laser pointer. Nothing more exciting than that, except at the end, we've got a special coupling that allows us to couple this into the end of our fiber. The idea behind these things is if you're working on fibers in the field and you want to identify, you've got a fiber bundle of 100 fibers or whatever, and you want to know which connectors, you can just couple this up to one connector at one end and you can see the light output from the other. It's as simple as that. This thing made me chuckle when I took it out of its case. The warning label on there actually says this is an eczema laser. If you could buy an eczema laser for $15, I would be super happy. But it is just a standard red laser, so a laser diode. And if we shine it on the work surface there, we can see we actually have a very large divergent beam because this is designed to be coupled straight into the end of a fiber. So let's see that. So I'll just hook this up to a short piece of telecoms cable real quick and we can see what it does. I'll just pop the cap off and couple it in. And if I turn the thing on, we can see that the end is really quite well illuminated already. So it's, this thing's obviously coupling a decent amount of light into the end of the fiber. And if we pop the cap off, we can see our quite divergent beam emerging there. And if I take my homemade ST connector, or collimator, we can plug that in and we can collimate the beam into a nice tight spot again, which is very, very useful indeed. So we're gonna get the optical bench out and I'm gonna show you how to use this in order to quickly and easily couple any laser into the end of a fiber cable. So let's take a look. So I have the optical bench set up here. If we're gonna couple laser light into the end of a fiber, we need some kind of mechanical stability and this optical bench is perfect for that. If you don't have one, a slab of aluminium will do, so long as things are bolted down and not held down with hot snot and gravity, you'll do just fine. We need 2 degrees of freedom in order to steer the beam into the end of the fiber, and so I've got 2 adjustable mirror mounts with what look like 1 1/4 inch mirrors mounted on them. I've got my 488 nanometer laser diode at the back there that I want to couple in, and so we're about ready. The first thing that we need to consider before doing this is laser powers. So this laser is about 30 milliwatts. It's so high that I can feel the heat on the tip of my finger. And so we need to turn this down because at some point we're going to have 2 laser beams pointing at each other. And if 30 milliwatts of 488 nanometer light manages to reach the facet of the laser diode in the fault locator, it will damage the laser diode and then that'll be that. So I have the power turned down on the laser now to just above threshold. We can see a spot on a piece of card there. That'll be just perfect for alignment purposes. We may be looking at about, maybe a milliwatt or so. Perfect. So we will put a collimator on one end of the fiber. And put that in our mount. Once again, all secured mounts, good. And if we take a look, there'll be no light exiting the fiber at this point because we're well off alignment. If we take our fault locator and plug it into the other end and turn it on, what we will have is the spot from the fault locator is being projected out of the collimator and onto the card there. The thing about the spot from the fault locator is, it's guaranteed to be on axis, right? So all that we need to do is line up the 2 laser beams until they're perfectly aligned end to end in this optical path. So I'll first of all line them up over here. And then we'll come back to this side and line it up. So what we're doing here is we're making sure that the beams are on axis at each end of the optical setup. And if they're on axis at each end of the optical setup, then that means that they will be on axis when they're coupled into the fiber. So we'll just go from end to end to end until we're happy that those things are perfectly on top of each other. And that is more or less it. At this point, we should be able to uncouple the fault locator and we will have light exiting the end of the fiber. So we're almost there. The very last job is to really walk in the beam until we're happy with the amount of power that we're coupling in. Ideally, we would do this with a laser power meter. I don't have one handy just at the moment, but by eye will be good enough. Perfect. So I'm reasonably happy with that. I think there's a fair bit of tweaking to be done there. Oh, that's pretty good. I'll just keep going, just a bit. Yeah, I think I'd be happy enough with that. There's a fair amount of light being coupled through. And I'll put a collimator on this end. And we'll be able to see our collimated beam. Excellent. At this point, we'll turn up the power. Fantastic. Look at that. Beautifully collimated beam out of the end of the fiber. Excellent. Everybody loves laser beams in smoke, so let's do an obligatory smoke shot. Absolutely fantastic. Beautiful. Excellent. When we want to couple light into a single mode cable, like this 35 meter length of telecoms cable, we need to make sure that the laser we're using has exceptional beam quality. This particular telecoms cable, its core diameter is only 9 microns, and so we need to focus our laser light into a 9 micron spot on the end of the cable, and this is not very trivial, even with this setup. It's the same setup as before. We've still got the two mirrors to steer the beam into the end of the coupler. It just takes a little bit more time to finesse the beam and get the maximum output power from it. That being said, let's turn this on. It's only roughly coupled, but we'll take a look so we can see our beam being injected into the end of the fiber. We can see already here that there's a considerable amount of light leaking out of the first 12 inches of fiber or so, and this is because some of that light is being coupled down the actual cladding layer in the fiber, so we're losing quite a bit of light that way. That said, we've got a very nice collimated beam coming out of the end of the fiber, and for some of the things I have lined up, this should be just fine. Excellent. We've got a nice, you know, tightly collimated spot. On the subject of light leaking out of fibers, if we take this fiber and bend it past its bend radius, green light will start to leak out of the edges of the fiber. It'll bounce out through the core and out of the cladding, and we can see it illuminating the edge of the fiber there. I mean, we shouldn't really abuse fibers in this way, but we can actually use this for sensing. You can actually, you know, mount a detector at the end of the fiber there and detect, well, how much light is passing through it. And if we bend the fiber, it will make the spot dimmer. And so we can sort of infer how much the fiber has been bent or stretched. There are other things we can do as well. I mentioned earlier on that you can measure voltages with fiber optic cable. We can measure magnetic fields and all sorts of cool stuff. So yeah, we'll have a look at some of these things in future videos. Thanks for watching this episode of Les's Lab. If you want to see more content like this, don't forget to hit like and subscribe down below, and I'll see you guys next time.